covering all of Southern California. This is CBS 2 News Central at 11.
If some of your Christmas gifts are still sitting in the boxes they came in, it may be time to think about recycling them. Tonight, CBS 2's Susie Sah has secrets to regifting to make sure you don't get caught.
With the holidays all wrapped up now, what to do with all that unwanted?
I got a t-shirt this year. It wasn't my thing.
Unnecessary.
Cookie jars.
It's not that the gifts were unappreciated.
I have a brother and he's awesome and he's, he like tries really hard with gifts.
But you just have that understanding of where they're going to end up.
You just leave it in the closet and then when it's time for an office party, you bring that out.
That's right. He said it. Some may fear it's a faux pas.
That's totally wrong.
But Hollywood resident Aaron Testa has no shame when it comes to the game of re-gifting.
Yep, that's what my mama taught me. Oh, like, Mom, what are those gifts or what's that cookie jar? Like, can we use it? And she's like, no, we're going to use it later.
You know, taking a gift you received and giving it to someone else in the guise of a new gift. Maybe for a birthday, a housewarming party.
I have done it. I do it. I'm not going to lie.
According to Money Management International, 60% of Americans believe reusing, recycling is really okay. No longer just for the cash-strapped, frugal, or unashamed.
I'm a broke college student.
Some people just literally don't have the money to go out and buy a new gift.
Lisa Gachet, an etiquette expert with Beverly Hills Manor, says there are rules for repackaging.
First of all, don't say it's a re-gift to the recipient. Many people have stories where they've actually opened a gift and they've seen a card to the original recipient.
The idea is to re-gift responsibly. For starters, stay away from re-gifting within the same circle of friends. Keep in mind who gave you that gift originally. And does that person know the person you're re-gifting it to?
Remember, not everything is meant for re-gifting.
Is not their style, is not their taste. That looks like you just literally dragged it out from the closet and threw it in a brown paper bag and threw it at them.
Make sure the gift is in good working condition.
Just giving that complete inspection to make sure that what you're giving is whole.
Then it's time to cover up your tracks.
You have to do what I call the equivalent of a Silkwood shower and remove all prior evidence of the past.
You know, like you see the tape marks and everything, you got to tape at the same place. So when they open it, they can't be like, oh, look at that mark right there. This is a re-gift.
Also remember, presentation is everything.
Take the time to wrap it very nicely with beautiful wrapping. Write a thoughtful note.
On the flip side of things, etiquette also comes into play when you're the one receiving a re-gift.
Don't call it out. Don't tell the person, you know, I know that you re-gifted me. Just accept it graciously.
If it really is the thought that counts, taking the time to think before you re-gift will make for a pleasant present for all parties involved.
It's taking it to the next level and really thinking about if that recipient would enjoy something.
From Santa Monica, Susie Sah, CBS 2 News.
And Susie says the most popular regifting choices are wine, champagne, and candles.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, sure.
That one guy with the glasses, he's got some experience. That guy.
Well, he said, my mama taught me.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Guy's an expert.
And now everybody's going to know, though, if they saw that.
Jackie, what was the bit about the umbrella keeping one handy?